there's good guys out there, which, by the way, is another thing that my pregnancy changed because I had a boy. I was very much a man hater before I had my son. And now I'm like, I'm still very much a girl's girl, but I'm more of like an ally of all people versus just women now, because I look at my son and how pure and innocent he is. And I'm like, there's a little Milo and all these men out there. Like, they have a mom that thinks about them the way that I think about my son. And that's really helped me see that when every single experience that you're having every day is just out of the norm, like, it just changes the way that your brain is wired.
Your perception of reality.
Yeah, your perception.
Honestly, like, you know me, I just think that who you are, you become more of. And I don't care how you dress it up, how you spin it. I don't care if you put different clothes on it. I don't care that you then had a child and that supposedly changed your perception of how things are. All of the videos that you did in the past still exist. Everything is still there. I haven't even got to the transformation, because she looks like a completely different person from what we were reporting on as far as who it is that her baby daddy is. For those of you that's not familiar, right, Lana Rhodes is a chick that's basically for the streets, that's been recorded on camera, if we just want to put it lightly, right? Because, you know, we want to keep it PG or whatever. And she's largely been linked to several NBA players. She allegedly said that she was with Kevin Durant and Bruce Brown, I believe, and even, you know, it was reportedly confirmed that Blake Griffin is her child's father, right? So, A, I can't understand, and I always say this, and I had said this yesterday and the day before and the day before that and the day before that, right? And last year and yesteryear and so on and so forth. I can't understand how y'all dudes is just going raw, seeing it through. And it knows no bounds. It doesn't matter how much money you are, how high value you supposedly are, what socioeconomic status that you have, none of that. You just see it through. And y'all just let loose, and y'all wind up having a kid by these chicks, and it don't matter how many dudes that she been with. I guess body count really don't matter for most of y'all. It really doesn't matter. And so when I speak to not dealing with chicks for the streets or body count or whatever like that, I guess I'm only speaking to a small demographic of men that we're trying to save, and that we're trying not to convince them to see it through. Because I don't care how long ago it was or whatever, so on and so forth. I just can't imagine the possibility of having a child with a woman that is on camera doing some of the most ungodly things that a woman is not supposed to be doing on camera in the first place. Let alone the idea that she's admittedly, even though she was with them, she was admittedly previously a man hater, and it took for her to have a child by an NBA player, allegedly, for her to then see things a little bit differently as far as how she views men, because there's a little bit of her child in all men because they have mothers too. This is insane, man.
Deception, and I think that's why I made the choices that I made early on. And did this. I made tons of mistakes when I was younger, and I don't think that I would have made those mistakes if I had a healthier outlook or my brain was in a better place. Because I think what had happened was I did porn, and then I was able to remove myself from the situation where I was being exposed to extreme mental illness and just like traumatizing shit every single day. And so I come out here, I live on my own. My brain, like, I start to experience like the real world. I think my brain started to rewire itself and like heal. And that's when I realized that porn just...
It wasn't for you, right? We just gonna stop it right there, right? Because it's not for you, because you've already experienced it, and then you did it. You got the kid by the NBA player. Look, man, I just think that all of these women is chameleons. I'm not going for it. And I'm just, it's wild the way that she looks right there. Is what, maybe she, you know, it's a lot of people that were saying that she hit the wall or she's aging like milk. Probably, maybe. But then at the same time, maybe this is the way that she always really looked. And we've always just seen them dressed up and with makeup on and stuff like that. Check out the transformation. This is her before. And y'all will bust that down. Let me tell you something. Y'all will bust down Gollum. Y'all absolutely would bust down Gollum. 100%. I know y'all. I know who y'all are. I know y'all gonna see it through. I've seen y'all do worse. I've seen y'all do chicks with 10 baby daddies that had been on camera and y'all still be giving money over to only OF. You know what it is. You know what I'm saying? Look at the transformation. What happened? No sun, no tan, no nothing. But it really, it doesn't even really matter, to be honest with you, because again, once for the streets, I believe all for the streets. And if you want forgiveness, then ask God, don't ask me. That's between you and God. I don't have any forgiveness to give you because you've never done anything to me. The only thing that I'm going to do is observe your behavior and then use it as a talking point in order to warn other people of what not to do going forward in the future. It's like a thief, right? Yeah, you can change your life and you can no longer be a thief. That don't mean that I have to necessarily believe you because you've never stole anything from me. And so it's nothing to ask for forgiveness for. But don't ask me to view you differently because your past is just as relevant as your present. And so we're not just going to ignore the context clues and the signs in order to make sure that we protect ourselves against getting stolen from again. You know what I'm saying? So while, if you stole from him, why would I then allow for you? And it don't mean that I can't treat you like a human being. I'm not going to dehumanize you. I believe in your ability to be able to seek happiness and life, liberty, and pursuit of justice for all, right? Your ability to provide for yourself and all of that, I would never deny that. But at the same time, don't ask me to view you differently than what it is that you've put out there for the world to see and capitalized off of. You made a bunch of money, you got famous and all of that. If you didn't do all of that, you wouldn't be sitting on that couch right there having that with that microphone in front of your face, having a conversation about what it is that you see men as. Straight up. And so I'm just amazed. I'm amazed that y'all continue to extend grace where grace is not necessarily warranted. And to see the transformation is wild. Let me give y'all that one more. I don't even know if that's the same person. Yeah, that's the same person. It's crazy, though. The transformation is crazy. I don't know what's happening over there in her world, but it's unfortunate that y'all continue to put these chicks on a pedestal. And I tell y'all all the time, vet a woman for where it is that you going, not necessarily where you at. And then you won't find yourself having children and being a baby daddy to a woman else for the streets. Let me know what y'all think in the comments. I'm curious as to what y'all thoughts are. Also, on top of that, make sure you tap into the Patreon. That link is in the description. Tej Hanley, 30% off your first order plus a free gift. I'm curious as to what you guys say. Do you think that this woman has completely changed her perspective towards life? Which she very much has. I mean, she very much could have. But the fact that she's expressing her opinion on a podcast warrants us to have a discussion about it. Do you think that she's changed her perception? Or do you think that life is just beating her down and now it's changing how it is that she looks at things? Let me know in the comments. I'm curious as to what you guys think. Make sure you tap into the Patreon. Tap into the Millionaire Morning Show today. I'm out, fam.